Hello, so my name is Margo Farr, and we're at Errant Studios and Gallery, where I have an art studio, and I'm showing in the gallery a body of work called Dislocation. That's really about many of the ways that people and animals have been displaced, dispossessed of their lands. For many reasons, natural disaster, for the sake of environmental accomplishment and achievement, where many people are negatively impacted by it, people who leave home because of war, terrorism, persecution. So this show is really about the pull between people's drive to survive at all costs and the hope and hopefulness of that, and also the hopelessness that often it's just not really possible. So a lot of the work is the play between the two of those. My main work is usually in plaster gauze and beeswax, and in this show I've also used a lot of natural branches, magnolia, bamboo, and birch with paper. A lot of the paper has the words written on it that are in the video that's featured in the installation here. And working with leaves and found natural objects. So an example of that is these pieces, which are from my garden. So each of these are leaves that were collected green and then sewed on, and then they dry in place. So they're sewed as a little collage tapestry, and they become little garden samplers. They're peppermint, camellia, heuchera, japonica, and one of the grasses, maybe sedge grass. Another example of how I work with natural materials is these pieces that are all magnolia branches from my magnolia tree with their growth on them. And then I build these little lichen pods out of plaster gauze, bandage, and beeswax and oil paint to create just these little clusters of community, of world, in the miniature focused in on the world. And these, they're attached to the shelves, and I created these floating shelves so that then they just slip on and they sit on the wall. And then another example of the boats and vessels for getting to safety is this one, which is really an homage to Leonardo with the wings. And this boat, it moves, but it's never going to get you anywhere. And it's just, again, that play between the hopefulness, the striving to survive, with the fact that none of these vessels are really ever going to be seaworthy or get someone somewhere. And yet, the hope with the wings, with the wheels, with this kind of magic talisman in it. And this one is called Where There's a Will, because really, just the hopefulness of human beings to get to safer places.
Can you move what was consecrated? Can you move that exact empty space in the earth I was about to lie next to him for eternity? It's the loneliness of eternity I'm talking about. Can you move all those things?
The flooding situation in parts of southern British Columbia forced farmers to lean on each other to save their animals. Many of the farms are in the Sumas Prairie in Abbotsford, a low-lying, fertile stretch of land created by the draining of a lake nearly a century ago. The land had historically been a critical resource area for the BC Indigenous communities. The evacuation order included 121 dairy and poultry farms. Officials were racing to carve out routes in impassable areas to get veterans.